Did you wake up today feeling frazzled? Were you in a beastly mood? Well, don't call the doctor just yet. This bug will be over by midnight. You're suffering from calendaritis. The culprit? Friday the 13th.
Triskaidekaphobia, fear of the number 13. Believe it or not, it costs this country some $1 billion every year due to canceled travel plans or missed work. Even in Boston, some of the finer hotels pass over the 13th floor or don't have rooms with 13 in them. What is everyone so afraid of? Bad luck, says Boston College history professor and In Search of Dracula author Raymond McNally. The number 13 possesses a long, dark past.
Most people think immediately of the Last Supper and Judas Iscariot, who was the 13th apostle at that dinner and who was the traitor and the evil person. So that's bad news. Hence, at a dinner table, you never have a dinner party for 13 people. It's just not done. It's taboo.
And Friday is just as cursed.
That's when Jesus Christ's passion occurred and when he was crucified. So it's a bad day. Supposedly Friday was the day that Eve gave Adam the apple to eat that started all the trouble.
So Friday the 13th is not a good combo, says McNally.
It's double jeopardy, as it were. It's a bad day to start. You shouldn't start anything. You should delay everything, any projects you have. I'm all for that.
No surprise that superstition thrives in this country, says McNally. After all, we dwell in a society bewitched by horror. Movies, music, and mystery books, they all aim to startle and shock, to rivet and rattle.
Most people like to be frightened under controlled conditions. You see, in a movie, is if it gets too much, you can close your eyes and or turn away. If you're reading a book and it gets too much for you, you can put it down. You're in control.
But as Boston Globe film critic Jay Carr adds, because our culture oozes with blood and guts, scaring us is no easy task.
Frankenstein and Dracula have turned into Saturday morning cartoon figures. We see them on cereal boxes, so you have to keep ratcheting this stuff up.
Keep the pressure on for Blood Rising, says actor Kane Hodder, who plays Jason in the Friday the 13th movie series. His movie motto, as you might expect, no guts, no gory. I mean, glory.
You know, everybody likes to get the buildup of the suspense and then the scare and the kind of the release of tension. And I just think it's a fun time.
Hodder might think of it as just fun, but parapsychologist Raphael Bibbo takes spooks seriously.
I definitely believe that the spirits and ghosts do exist.
Bibbo's business, busting ghosts, although his main line of work is civil engineering. Today, he's nosing around the Johnstone Inn in Ashland, supposedly a longtime haunt for the ghost of John Stone, who was said to have murdered one of his guests. Also said to be seen, the image of a little girl who was killed by a passing train on the railroad tracks next door.
I usually like to just walk around casually, walk through the place, and allow myself to be receptive to any feelings that I could have. And 9 times out of 10, there are certain, I call them like hot spots, somebody may call them cold spots. If I pass through one of those spots, you have a tingling sensation that comes up through the spine and you feel like goosebumps that come on your hands and you know that you've hit something. They want to communicate. They want some notification, hey, look, we're here.
The scary part for us mortals, Bibbo says, is that we don't know how to react towards something we can't explain.
It's the unknown factor that you can't see. It's fear of the unknown.
There are many things that we don't understand out there in the universe. And anybody who says they understand everything is probably a fool. We don't know many of the answers to the basic questions. Science can't tell us the meaning of life. So there's an area where science has no answers, and into that area comes superstition.
Still, McNally says that science and history offer reasonable explanations behind many mysteries and superstitions. But if all this talk is still making you tense, fear not, there's always tomorrow, the 14th.
Ha 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 ha